guys, so welcome back to my channel. It's your girl GH Kings. So on this video, I just want to share with you guys how I lost, or I have been losing, my quarantine weight. Okay, so I started gaining weight from March, when we started being quarantined, when we got stuck at home. Okay, so I think around the last week of July, that's when I looked so pregnant. Okay, I looked like I was pregnant. I look like somebody just injected me with water. Like, you, I look like someone injected me with fat, pure fat. Okay, so like, I was like, girl, what's up? And like, almost all my clothes were not fitting, except for the clothes that were already big. Okay, those are the ones that were fitting comfortably. So I was like, it's time for you to actually start losing weight. Okay, and naturally, I'm the type of person that during the summertime, I tend to gain a lot of weight. Okay, I tend to gain a lot of weight because summertime, I'm not really that active. I just go out, chill with friends, go to the park, just eat, sleep, and, you know, do those kind of stuff. But, you know, during the regular seasons, you know, I have schoolwork, I have this part-time job that I do, so I got time to be gaining weight. You know, I'm very active, basically, that's what I'm trying to say. And I also have noticed that with me, losing weight is not about going to the gym, okay? Because I notice every time I go to the gym, I actually gain weight. I do gain muscle weight, and that actually demotivates me, you know, to even exercise and stuff like that. So I have said to myself, you know what, for gym, right now I haven't been going to gym. I'm gonna go to gym once I hit 150, because that way I want to tone up my butt. You know, I still want my butt to be perky and all that. I want to tone it up, and this extra skin that I have on my back, I want it to go, and just tone up my arms and try to do ab exercises to, you know, lose belly fat. Because I've noticed, even though I've been losing weight, it's like the fat in my belly is still there. So I think when I'm 150, I'm going to start going to the gym and see if I by myself I can drop to 145, which is my actual goal, to 125 to 150. But when I get to 145, I'm going to get a personal trainer to see if he or she can help me to, you know, really lose this belly fat. Because I feel like, I don't know, I have been losing so much weight, but my belly fat is like still there. So if I do get the personal trainer, I will do a whole series on that, okay, for you guys. But for today, I just want to share with you guys the tips, the tricks, everything that I use to actually lose this 10 pounds, okay, that I gained during quarantine. And I have lost this 10 pounds using 2 months, okay? So I gained 10 pounds in 5 months, and I've lost 10 pounds. I gained 10 pounds in 5 months, and I have lost 10 pounds in 2 months. But I know I still need to lose more weight, okay? Let me explain. So pre-quarantine, I was in school, and I was gaining a lot of weight because of the stress associated with the schoolwork and everything in my life, and me thinking about my life, my future, and everything. I gained, like, I think I gained 10 pounds. Because, like I said, I used to be 145, 150. I just found myself weighing 155. I was like, oops, from 145 to 155. And I was never able to lose that 10 pounds, okay? And then quarantine came in, and I gained 10 pounds on top of that. So, in total, I had 20 good pounds that I needed to lose, okay? So in August, I was like, you know what, I'm not looking sexy, I have curvy shape, I'm not seeing them curves, okay? I'm not seeing them curves. So like, you need to do something. You're not even married yet, you can't start looking anyhow, okay? You need to get this shape on point. So I was like, you know what, I'm going to start dieting, okay? Because like I said, I know going to the gym really wasn't gonna help me. I know it's gonna get me energy and all that, but it wasn't really gonna help me lose any weight, okay? So I started dieting, and I didn't go on a serious diet because I have been on a diet before and it failed, okay? So the kind of diet that I actually went on was staying away from a lot of carbohydrates. I'm not saying staying away from carbohydrates, because I'm African, my favorite food is made out of carbohydrates, so I can't stay away from carbohydrates. But I tried my best. And I tried substituting things, okay? So one thing that I do now is that I no longer eat white rice, okay? I do eat brown rice nowadays. Yeah, for the past month to two now, I have been eating brown rice, and I actually like it, okay? I do like it. I have found my way of cooking brown rice for it to, you know, taste like the way I want it to. you know, and other stuff. I even use brown rice to make fried rice, y'all. So like, I've been trying my best, and also I have been eating a lot of veggies. Okay, I have been eating a whole different veggies, a whole lot of veggies I have been eating. And I also make sure that on a weekly basis I purchase like one or two different kind of fruits. Like this week I have cantaloupe, and also I had some leftover pineapples. I need to still chop up the cantaloupe, but a girl has been busy, but I kind of need to do that tomorrow or today because I need to eat that cantaloupe. Okay, it's been sitting in the fridge for a long time. So that's what I do. I eat more fruits now, and like on a regular day I just eat one meal. Okay, I eat one meal. Are you guys like, are you not hungry? No, y'all, like I don't get hungry. Okay, I don't get hungry like that. So I eat one meal, but then for the rest of the day I have fruits. I drink a lot of water. That's what I've been doing. And also I work a lot. I have been working, yo. Sometimes I work for like an hour, not like an hour straight. I work to a place for like maybe 25 minutes, you know, and then I walk back, you know, to my house, be another 25 minutes, making 50 minutes, and I'll just decide to just walk around my neighborhood for like, you know, 10-15 minutes, and then come back home, you know. And like, that's what I do. And also on my when I don't go to work, those days I just take the bus, go to the mall, and just do window shopping. And once I've been roaming about in there for like an hour or something. Like, I have this thing on my Samsung phone that it tracks how much or how many steps you've taken. Once I reach that step, I'm like, okay, I think it says 1,000 steps a day. I try to reach that every single day. Okay, sometimes I go past it, sometimes I'm just right there, sometimes I'm like a little bit below it. So that's what I do. So yeah, I've been working a lot. I do work a lot, and I've noticed, you know, that working actually helps me to lose weight. I'm not joking. Like, I noticed in 2015, towards 2015 to 2016, before I graduated with my first degree, that summer I had a summer job on campus. Okay, and I was working, yo, I was working full time, yo, but just for the summer. And I was like, the job required that I stay on my feet the whole 8 hours, well, 7 hours, you know, because you have an hour break. And y'all, I lost so much weight. Okay, I was able to get some good graduation dress. So I noticed with me, working actually helps me to burn a lot of calories. Working actually helps me to lose weight, like overall weight, you know, like even like now my arm is actually slimming up now and I love it. So working is like my go-to when it comes to losing weight, you know. But it's just interesting because though I lose all this weight, my tummy, I'm losing the tummy weight, you know, but I still like it feel like, or it seems like I still have a lot of work when it comes to my tummy. That's what I'm saying, like I'm gonna get a personal trainer next year. I'm definitely getting a personal trainer. But let's start with the weight. So like I said, I was 145 before I started this program that I was doing. I end up with being 155 because of stress, because of eating out late at night, and all that stuff that came with going to school. Quarantine came, I was stuck at home doing nothing but eating and sleeping and watching some good movies. I gained 10 pounds, but now I have been able to lose this 10 pounds, and I've said everything that I've did. Okay, I didn't do anything fancy. I tried clothing for like a week and it was actually working, but I just don't have the time. And when I can't put my all into something, I just stop, because it's like it's wasting my time. I can't just be doing this today, not doing it tomorrow, and then come back the following day to be doing it. I need to be consistent. Okay, and I noticed walking works for me. Okay, walking just works, and that's what I've been doing. I've been eating so much healthy. Okay, yes. And also I do drink almond milk. Like every week I drink a gallon of almond milk. It's just the unsweetened one. It's just, I think it's 30 calories. That one is unsweetened. That's all I drink. I stopped eating bread. Okay, I don't remember the last time I had anything that has to do with bread. I don't eat bread. I also drink soup. I make healthy soups and I drink it sometimes, you know, because you, even though you're trying to lose weight, you still need to have fluids in you. You still need to have a lot of fluids. You need to drink a lot of water and all that stuff, you know. So basically that's what I've been doing, and I haven't really been snacking. I know some people do snack, but one thing that I started like last week was that I have been adding Ensure to my diet, you know, because I feel like Ensure, I actually noticed Ensure has a lot of, you know, vitamins and benefits in there, you know, that I think I'm not really getting because of the changes I've made to my diet, you know. So I do drink one Ensure every day. I mean, the one I buy is like, it's 6 in the pack, so yeah, basically. And it's I think it's a 280 calories or something like that. So whenever I drink that Ensure, I know I need to eat less, okay, because I already have some calories going on. And also the food that I've been making, it doesn't have a lot of calories, okay, even though I use a whole lot of ingredients and I get filled really quick, it doesn't have a lot of calories, so I don't really do calorie counts and all that. And I didn't, like, it was easy for me to drop 5 pounds, okay. Once I started changing my diet and I started working, the first month I lost the 5 pounds. But from towards the end of August to this beginning of November, it took me so long to lose this at that 5 pounds. Yo, it took me so long. I had to walk more, I had to walk faster, I had to eat less, I had to, you know, do things. But like, I'm actually happy. Like, I am currently in the weight that I actually was before starting this program that I was in, so I'm actually excited about that. And I know for me to lose this next 10 pounds, it's not gonna be easy, because even now, even though I've lost the 10 pounds, sometimes I go back to 155 point something. Sometimes I will just go at 156. When I sleep and I wake up, I'm like 155 point something. Like, Jesus, let this 155 stay there. I cannot be going up and down like that, okay? So even with this 155 that I'm talking about, it's not really like a constant 155. Sometimes it goes up, sometimes it goes down, you know? So I know it's gonna be really pretty tough to lose the next 10 pounds, because it wasn't easy losing this last 5 pounds. But with more determination, with me working more, with me even eating healthier, adding more greens, adding, you know, eating even with the brown rice, reducing it, and, you know, adding more plantains, or just, I don't know, like drinking more soup and stuff like that, it will work. And also with the diet, I don't wanna be on a diet that is going to be frustrating. I did that before and it's not worth it. I don't wanna be on a diet where I'm like, oh, I'm going to cut this thing from my diet, I'm going to cut this thing from my diet. No, I stop eating bread because, first of all, it gives me constipation. Second of all, like, I'm not a bread lover like that, so I stop eating bread, you know. But I like my rice, so I try to find a substitute for it. So the things that I love to eat, I try to find substitutes, you know, for that. And also when it comes to meat, I haven't really been eating meat. If you guys know, I'm not really the meat kind of person. I do my chicken here and there, even chicken. For these whole 2 months, I think I've had chicken like twice or something. I don't really been doing that chicken, that meat kind of thing. I've just been, you know, like veggies. That's been my thing, veggies. And like eating less, veggies and eating less. So yeah, that's what I've been doing, and like, it has been working, okay? It has been working. And I did add the Ensure for a good reason, because I feel like there are still some vitamins and stuff that I'm probably not getting because of me being picky, a little bit picky with the stuff that I eat. But yeah, so far this is where I'm at. I'm actually excited because now my clothes actually do fit, and I got myself some other clothes and they do fit and they actually look nice on me, and I'm feeling myself a little bit, you know what I'm saying? But you know, a girl needs to create her schedule right so I can start going to the gym and, you know, tuning up my body a little. Like I said, I want to tone up places that needs to be toned up, okay? And also, I actually thought that my boobs, you know, will actually get smaller, because I thought, like, you know, like maybe my boobs got bigger over the last 2-3 years because I was gaining a lot of weight. But you know, as I've been sitting there thinking to myself and like, noticing that I can't show you guys my boobs, you know, but like, it's not because of me gaining weight. I think it's just genetics. My boobs were not done growing, okay? So, but I feel like it's still silly though, because I'm like 26, okay? But yeah, I don't know. I think I need to create a whole video on this, okay? Because it's just weird. Yeah, I'm definitely, after this video, I'm definitely going to create a whole, oh my god, it don't sound right. But I'm definitely going to be creating a video on that. So yeah, I think I'll end this one here, and, you know, just make sure that in a couple of days, you just come back, you know, and just see, you know, what I talked about, because I think I need to create a whole video on my boobs, because, like, I don't know if it's just me, or it's normal, or it's not normal, okay? I need to create a whole video on that, and bras and all that stuff. So yeah, I think I'll just save it for another video because this one is pretty long already. So anyway guys, this is how I actually lost this 10 pounds, and I'm actually excited because now I can see like my face is not like that chubby like it used to, and you know, yeah, but I'm going to be really more excited if I'm able to lose this other 10 pounds before my birthday, which is February. So we have November, December, January, February, like in the next 3 months. I'm stretching to that long because I know it's not gonna be easy for me to lose this 10 pounds. Okay, so if I'm able to lose the 10 pounds by February, I'm going to be so excited because then around the summer I'm going to get a personal trainer to see if I can, you know, get up to 140 and just remain there in 140. I don't want to lose more than that, okay, before I have a big head and skinny body like that. No, I like my body, okay. I want some body on this thing, okay. So yes, 145 will be perfect for me, okay. So that's my goal, 140 to 145. If I get a personal trainer, I just want to lose the belly fat but gain some muscles, so still be between 140, you know, range between 140 and 145. That's where I want to be, you know. So yeah, it's not my goal to go back to 165. That's how much I was during quarantine. I lost myself. I look like a balloon, okay? I look like a balloon. I was like, hey, Jesus, where is my butt? Hey, Jesus, where is my shape? That was me during quarantine, okay? I'm like, nah, girl, before this lockdown is over, I need to fix this thing, okay? So, yeah, little things like this is how I managed to lose weight. And let me tell you something. There are different ways to lose weight, okay? Your way of losing weight might not work for me, so let me just say that, like I said, with me, going to the gym doesn't really help me, but walking actually does help me, because going to the gym I tend to gain weight, but when I walk and I try to, you know, eat healthier, like they say, you know, diet is like, how do I say it, contributes about 80% when it comes to you losing weight. So try to eat a bit more healthier. I'm not saying throw away stuff that you eat, but try to find substitutes for the stuff that you like, you know. Like me, I love stews and stuff like that. Now I put a lot of veggies, okay, and like, I don't know, I put a lot of veggies in my stew and stuff like that. I like my pasta. I eat whole grain pasta, and I make sure the sauce that I actually making the sauce myself, and I have, you know, all this healthy stuff in it. So basically that's it. That's what I've been doing, just doing things at your own pace, you know. Don't try to be like, I need to lose this weight. And like, sometimes when we set a date for ourselves, like, you know what, by this time I need to lose weight, it kind of doesn't motivate us. But if you are trying to set a date for yourself, try to be realistic with that date, okay? And even me, when I noticed that I have lost 10 pounds, eh, this last 5 pounds I wasn't really weighing myself. I was like, you know, I forget this, I didn't even know I have lost weight, you know. But when I wear dresses, you know, I'm like, it seems like this thing is a bit loser, you know. So I was like, you know what, let me just step on the scale. I stepped on the scale a few days ago, and like, I saw that a girl is not 155, y'all. Yeah, a girl is 155. So I got 10 more pounds to, you know, to lose, but we will get there one day at a time. So anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I love you, and as always, God loves you more. And also, if you have any questions pertaining to weight loss and whatnot, leave your comments in the comment section, okay? I have also created a lot of videos when it comes to me cooking, so you guys will actually see or have been seeing the kind of meals that I have been making and all that stuff, okay? So yeah, I have my cooking series too. I'm going to try to leave that in the description section as well, so you guys can check them out to see the kind of meals that I've been eating and all that stuff. But till then, I love you all, and as always, God loves you more. And I hope you guys subscribe, like, and share. See you guys on my